Hi, everybody. I'm Jared Pike. This is Shell Point Today for Wednesday, January 8th. On today's show, we learn how urology can be a very different discussion topic for men and women. We'll also talk with Sally Rich, who will soon be showcasing her beautiful photographs of great blue herons. But first, did you know that gardening is actually good exercise? Not only do you enjoy the outdoors, but you also enjoy the accomplishment of a successful planting and socializing with your fellow gardeners. You can learn how to garden for your health at today's Garden Society meeting, happening at 11 a.m. in the Woodlands Oak Room. Join special guests Melanie Brode, C.J. Galata, and Michelle Smith to learn the right ways to plant, water, and weed without breaking your back. All are welcome to attend, whether you have a garden or not. Now, there's another way you can have beautiful flowers in your home. Make them yourself, using seashells. What better material can there be for Shell Point? And the bouquets that result can be amazing. Find out how to make these shell flowers at an academy class taught by Star Ramsey. It begins tomorrow at 2 p.m. in the Sable Room at the Woodlands, so sign up today. And then, this evening is a special night in the Crystal Room because it's singles night. Now, for some people who don't have another person to enjoy a meal with, it can sometimes be tough to venture out to a place like the Crystal Room. But now, Shell Point is providing a place for you. The Crystal Room now offers a singles table every Monday and Wednesday evening, starting at 5:30 p.m. The purpose of the singles table is not to match people up. It's just to offer a fun place where single people can enjoy a meal with the company of others without feeling like they have to eat alone. To find out more or to make reservations, call the Crystal Room at 454-2199. Now, one quick note about the singles table. If you want to enjoy pleasant conversation, it's best to avoid a topic like urology. Stuff like that just doesn't play in mixed company. So, with that in mind, we are actually splitting men and women for a health connection event. Because urological issues are important, but very different for men and women. So, a male and a female urologist will be addressing men and women next Wednesday, January 15th, at 2:15 p.m. in two different sections of the Social Center. Mary Franklin has this preview.
I'm Mary Franklin with an upcoming Health Connections program. It's going to take place on Wednesday, January 15th at 2:15 in the Social Center, and it is Ask the Urologist, men only and women only. We're splitting you up this time. We will have two presenters. Ladies will go with Leanne Boyd, and the gentlemen will go with Dr. Blitz, and it will be a unique situation. Thanks for being here, both of you.
Thanks for having us. Sure.
Dr. Blitz, tell me a little bit about you.
Well, I'm from Hollywood, Florida, so I'm born and bred Floridian. There's some that do exist. I did my training at University of South Florida, but more importantly, I did all my surgery and urology training at University of Chicago. And as far as urology, I'm in group practice with Florida urology physicians. Leanne is one of our premier providers as well. And I spend most of my days worrying about whether or not the Miami Dolphins are going to make it to the playoffs.
All right. Leanne, what about you?
Well, actually, I'm almost a Floridian. Okay. I like to say I'm a Florida cracker with a bite taken out of it. I was here since I was a year old, so I grew up right here in town.
All right.
I went to school at Edison, and then I did my master's training at Florida International University in North Miami. Okay. And like Dr. Blitz, I've been in urology for over 20 years now, and I can't imagine doing anything else. It just comes naturally to me.
A lot has changed in urology over the last couple of years. Dr. Blitz, what can the gentleman expect out of your presentation?
Well, you know, we're going to have a men's and a woman's presentation coming up. During mine, I'm going to talk about some of the big topics. I don't want to talk, you know, forever on each of the topics, because my big goal is to talk a little bit about PSA, because there's a lot of controversy about it. We're going to talk about some prostate cancer, but we'll also talk about, you know, some of the other main topics, which is going to be urinary issues.
Right.
We're going to talk about several topics but I'm really going to be focused on having question answer. And one thing that I do request at any of my question answers is that no one asks questions about themselves. Mm-hmm. Any question has to be about someone they know, like their friend or their brother, not about yourself. And I'll get a good answer for you.
Oh, good, good. And Leanne, there's a lot happening with the ladies' side of things.
Absolutely. We also deal with the hormonal issues. Mm-hmm. That's a big, important issue for us as well. And we deal with a lot of other issues with women. And I, like Dr. Blitz, is going to mention some of the minor topics, spend a few minutes on each, but allow people to just ask us questions. And again, for HIPAA, we don't want to give out any information we shouldn't be disclosing. So you want to say it's a friend or someone you know, so that we don't give out information to the whole group. But we're going to be talking about things such as urinary incontinence, overactive bladder. I'll even touch on kidney stones and urinary tract infections and a lot of the issues that will impact women. We have a lot of new treatments coming out, some new class of medications. We also have some non-surgical options, which are really wonderful for patients that have urinary incontinence issues or overactive bladder issues. And some of these things they can actually do at home. And that's a big move for us, because before we had to use physical therapy and you had to go to an outside source, and it becomes very expensive for patients. So these are things that patients have a lot of control over. And patients are big advocates for their own health care, and I think this is great because they can really impact their control as far as their overactive bladder.
I do see the trend in people without any medical issue, but they want to take control and help be part of the solution and be advocates for themselves. Are there things diet-wise? I know urology is a big topic, but there are things that, right, that you can do. It's not all you have it and you just got to deal with it. Are there things you can do at home?
Well, one thing I wanted to mention is I think many of us are over-medicating patients. Mm-hmm. The average patient, if they're on four medications or more, there's an 80% chance there's going to be some sort of medication interaction. Mm-hmm. And I think we have to move to not just being on chronic medical therapy, but to do more things that are curative, mm-hmm. but not necessarily surgery. And so what Leanne was mentioning, there are several techniques that we have, including at-home physical therapy, where there's actually an FDA medical-approved device mm-hmm. that a woman can take home to self-correct her urinary incontinence or voiding issues, and that can actually cure her without surgery, without medicine. Mm-hmm. And so I think that it's really important that one thing that patients need to do is question us. You know, we're doctors, we want to come up with an answer and a solution, but sometimes the treatment's worse than the disease. Before embark on any treatment program, really, you know, push your doctor and say, well, is this going to be a medicine I'm going to have to always be on? Or is this going to cure me? Or what can I do, like you said, on my own to try to fix this? Mm-hmm. And I think that the more things that we can do proactively and not just continue medical therapy, the better it's going to be.
Well, I think the most important thing is all Shell Point residents should feel comfortable coming to your talk. It's going to be one of those open and honest conversations. We all have some sort of issue, and we're all going to be understanding in the room. So it's not a place where people have to be embarrassed to ask anything, and definitely we'll get their questions answered. So I encourage all the residents here, if you have any questions in the area of urology, to attend this session. I am thankful you came out today to give us a little slice of what you're going to be presenting. And if you would like to sign up for this program, once again, it's going to take place on Wednesday, January 15th in the Social Center at 2:15 p.m. You can sign up at either of the service desk and come and have all of your questions answered. I'm Mary Franklin with Dr. Blitz and Leanne Boyd. Make it a happy and healthy day.
Coming up tomorrow, we have a free event for anyone interested in history, especially from the unique perspective of a First Lady. Lucretia Garfield was First Lady for just 6 months after her husband, President James Garfield, was assassinated. Hear a portrayal of Lucretia Garfield from actress Damaris Peters Pike, who will also perform songs from the Civil War. The drama of Lucretia Garfield is open to all tomorrow at 2 p.m. in the Grand Cypress Room. And for those who love nature, there's drama every day here at Shell Point, right outside your window. Some days it may be a bald eagle nesting in a nearby pine tree. Other times it could be great blue herons wading in the shallow water. You can experience these amazing birds through the lens of Sally Rich of Teledora, whose photos have been featured for years at the Ding Darling Wildlife Sanctuary on Sanibel. This week, she brings her focus to great blue herons at an Academy event on Friday at 2 p.m. in the Grand Cypress Room. Terry Kolath tells us more.
Hello, everyone. I am here today with Sally Rich of Teledora. If you do not know Sally, you are in for a treat. She is an extraordinary photographer, and she's going to share her talents with us on Friday, January 10th, as we look at the mating habits of the blue heron. This presentation came from something you did at Ding Darling just about a year ago. What was that?
Well, I had an exhibit. It was called an educational exhibit, and there were 30 images of the mating behaviors of great blue herons, and it was an opportunity for people to see something that very few people have seen.
We are going to be able to see photographs of the pictures that you had. I want to say I'm looking at this picture of Ding Darling and the couple of great blue herons in the tree. How in the world do you get these photographs? Where are you when you're taking this photograph?
Well, actually, I had a show on Captiva, and some people drew me aside and said, "We know of a nest on Captiva, and it's active, and it's on private property, and we'd like to for you to know about it, but you have to promise that you won't tell anybody else, because if people come around, the birds will desert their nests."
Oh, wow.
I gave my Girl Scout honor and got up here at Shell Point before dawn and took breakfast and lunch and got up to Captiva. And as you can see from the picture, it's not easy. I got some pictures. I got that picture from a pontoon boat. But you could trudge your way in, pulling a cart with your tripod and all that sort of thing. And that's what I did most of the time.
It occurs to me that you would have to be very strong to be able to do this. How do you keep up your physical abilities to actually do something like this that's so stressful for the body, even though it's exhilarating for the spirit?
Well, I had in the cart, I could put a director's chair and then unfold it. And you couldn't really sit on it, but you could definitely lean against it, you know. Uh-huh. And then I had the tripod, and I had an umbrella that I would sometimes, because sometimes it was hot and sometimes it was cold, because I was filming from the 15th of February until April 3rd. So I went, a lot. And the reason that it was, that you wanted to make that kind of effort was that when the birds are mating is when they display their fabulous feathers. Because when you see a great blue heron, they're majestic and stately, and their feathers are all in and they're very compact. But when they're mating, I have some pictures where they actually look like cavemen in fur. They're all expanded, and every kind of feather, their scapula, their neck, their nuptial plumes, their tail feathers, everything is expanded to attract the opposite sex. So you get the absolutely the best pictures when they are displaying like that.
It must feel wonderful that you can give us this gift. I mean, how many of us will have ever seen this except through the lens of Sally Rich?
Well, that's a nice observation on your part, because I think that, the real, I very much enjoy the interaction with the people who come. It's an opportunity for them to have an insight into nature that they might otherwise not have. They have had ones that I haven't had, but this is an opportunity for them to get to see this. So I'm happy about that.
And through the process that you go through this process, you know the great blue heron.
I know those gray blue herons pretty well, and it was just wonderful, and it was so wonderful to be included in that world and to be by myself, you know.
It is an amazing thing that you do, and we're so looking forward to sharing it. You are welcome to join Sally Rich Friday, January 10th. You'll be glad you did.
It's time now to cover all of Wednesday's happenings from Resort Services. Then, after your Academy news and menus, stay tuned for Village Church Connections.
Happy Wednesday, everyone. Thank you for tuning in with us today. My name is Leslie Brand, and this is Bev Chanley. And on this Wednesday, we have a lot going on, so make sure you pay attention to the activities going on. We're going to start bright and early at 7:45 with the men's Bible study, Osprey Room on the Island. Lily and Company Jewelers will be here for their weekly jewelry service at 8:45 on the Resident Activity Center. And also at 8:45 is the Resident Council in the Social Center on the Island. At 9 o'clock is a men's match play doubles tennis at the tennis courts at the Woodlands. Watercolor group with Phil Hilton's at 9 o'clock in the Art Studio. At 9:15 is scrapbooking group, come and go as you please in the Tarpon Room. 10 o'clock is a ladies' Bible study in the Osprey Room on the Island. And the Model Yacht Sailing Club is at 10:15 in the Commons Lake at the Woodlands. We have a Health Connections, a Specifics and Strength Training at 11:30 in the Health Club, but that class is full. And at 11 o'clock, the Shell Point Garden Society meeting presents Fitness and Gardening in the Oak Room at the Woodlands. Now here's Beth to tell you about the afternoon activities.
We're going to start out your afternoon at 1 o'clock, where you'll find chess played in the library lounge at the Resident Activity Center. At 1:15, we have a Health Connections class. It's all about you, chronic disease self-management program. That'll be in the Manatee Room. You do need to sign up for that one. From 1:30 to 3:30, we have the Model Train Room open for tours. 1:45, Health Connections class, Balance and Mobility Training Level 1 in the Health Club, and that is currently full. At 2:30, Jazz and Stuff will be playing in the Grand Cypress Room. 3 o'clock, Bible Study will be in the King's Crown Community Room. At 3 o'clock, we have a Health Connections Pilates Stretch. That'll be in the Health Club. Also at 3 o'clock, we have Memory Care Group on the third floor craft room at King's Crown. You do need to sign up for that. At 4:30, the indoor bocce will be set up down in the Health Club. And at 5:45, the church choir rehearsal will go on at the Village Church. And we round out the afternoon and evening with 7:15, prayer and praise at the Village Church. Well, we hope you all have a wonderful day out there at Shell Point, and we'll see you back here again tomorrow.
Hi, I'm Terry Coleth with your Academy information for Wednesday, January 8th. At 1 o'clock, Intermediate Bridge begins in the Game Room of the Woodlands, and sign-up is required. Also at 1 o'clock, Live Figure Drawing begins in the Sable Room of the Woodlands, and sign-up is required. At 1:45, the Computer College Prep School will start in the Computer Teaching Center on the Island. Sign-up is required. We have some new classes starting tomorrow. Math for Those Who Never Liked Math with Dick Brown of Parkwood, Story Writing with David Singer of Teledora, Apple iPad e-reader with Penny Modridge of Nautilus and Bruce Findlay of Sundial, and a Skype Basics course with Joe Kramer of Lakewood. Shell Flowers with Star Ramsey of Lakewood.
Menus for Wednesday. In the Crystal Room, the Crystal Platter is herb-roasted chicken with wild rice pilaf and carrots. The dinner special is the pasta buffet for $12.95, and the soup of the day is tortellini and sausage. In the Island Cafe for lunch, enjoy a smoked sausage sandwich with onion rings for $7.25. The dinner special is fried shrimp for $8.25. Dinner specials in the Palm Grill on Wednesday are shrimp pomodoro for $13.95 or grilled sirloin for $15.95. All menus are available 24 hours a day at www.shellpoint.net.
Greetings and welcome to Village Church Connections. I'm here with Arnie Shoresky. Welcome, Arnie.
Thank you. Good to be here.
Arnie serves on our missions committee at the Village Church. And Arnie, we are here to talk about one of the most important weeks in the year at the Village Church, and that is our Global Impact Week.
Right.
This year, that week is going to take place January 19th through the 26th.
And tomorrow we're going to talk a little bit about schedule, but today we want to talk about who our guests are going to be. And we have five very special guests that will be joining us for either part or all of the week. Beginning the week is somebody that you know fairly well, Dr. John Corby. Tell us a little bit about Dr. Corby.
John was a young student at Nyack College when I first met him. In fact, his father was the pastor of the church I attended. And John went to Nyack College and then later graduated and went off to Gabon as a missionary. He and his wife both went off together and served there for many, many years. Then later on, John moved to Europe and ministered in France and Germany and became a regional director. So John has had a great deal of experience in missionary work.
And I know John is a third generation missionary. His parents were missionaries, his grandparents were missionaries. And so missions is in John's blood.
Right.
And we are looking forward to that passion when he's here, because he'll have a lot to tell us. And currently he lives in Colorado Springs and is working as a liaison to churches, helping them understand what's going on around the world and partner with those projects. And he'll be our opening speaker for that first Sunday morning and then for our Monday night banquet. We'll talk a little bit more about that tomorrow.
All right.
We also have a special guest that will be closing our conference, and that is Betty Constance. Betty has been a career missionary in South America, particularly Argentina. We know Betty here at Shell Point because of the ministry of the Stamp Room.
Right. Yes, Betty and her husband were heavily involved in the training of pastors in Argentina, but then later got involved in the literature ministry for the Sunday schools and the training of children and adults as well, and later developed quite a publishing house. In fact, they did a lot of their writing and preparing of the material themselves. So David and Betty have been very active in providing excellent material for Sunday school teachers throughout Latin America in the Spanish language. And Betty is an excellent communicator as well. She really comes across as one who's totally sold out for the work that God has called her to do.
That's really true. I've heard Betty speak only a couple times, but I remember both of those times very clearly because of the impact she had on me.
Right.
So we're looking forward to those two guests. And then during the course of the week, we have some guests coming from other parts of the world. One of those is a couple from a creative access country. They are living and working in North and Central Asia. We have to protect their identity, so we can't talk a lot about them publicly. But tell us just a little bit about what it means to be working in a creative access country.
Creative access countries, from our viewpoint, are countries or governments that are not favorable toward Christian missionaries or Christian gospel. So we call them creative access countries because those who go to work there have to use creative means to be able to share the good news of the gospel and not to be offensive and yet have a reason to be there so that legitimately they can be in the country. They may get into a business, they may do a hairdressing place or a bakery or something else and allow that to become their avenue of approaching people. The work is slow, but it's meaningful nonetheless, and it's important that the people there have an opportunity to hear the good news of the gospel.
And I know this couple is living and working in an area of the world that is a pretty new work for the Christian Missionary Alliance. So it will be interesting to hear what they have to share.
Right. And we'll be very happy to hear what they've got to tell us.
And then our final guest for the week is Teresa Bill. She and her husband are currently living and working in the Congo, and I know you're familiar with the Congo.
They're living and working in the Congo Brazzaville. Mm-hmm. My wife and I are missionaries in Congo Kinshasa, just across the river. But the communities are pretty well the same. Primarily, or earlier in their lives, they went to Gabon and were missionaries there for many years, did an excellent work. But the church in Gabon is developed so well that missionaries have felt quite free to go to other areas. So these, what we now call international workers, have transferred to other countries, and they have gone to the Republic of Congo and doing an excellent work there as well.
And so Teresa will be sharing a little bit about what they're involved in there. And I know she works some in adult training ministries, but she also works with children's ministries. So she and Betty Constance will have some things in common.
They will indeed. They are both very competent speakers. We're looking forward to hearing from them.
We are. I feel very privileged to be able to have five unique servants here for the course of this week.
Right.
And we certainly invite you to come and join in for as much of the week as you possibly can. January 19th through the 26th, our Global Impact Week. And thank you for being with us today.
We're glad you joined us for today's show. Tune in tomorrow as we preview a new game coming to Shell Point this weekend, golf croquet. We'll also watch a flash mob of line dancers who took over Shell Point's outdoor marketplace at Christmas time. Until then, this is Shell Point Today for Wednesday, January 8th. I'm Jared Pike, and from all of us here at Shell Point TV, we hope you have a great day, and we'll see you again tomorrow.